It hasn't been too bad of a decade for war movies. Dunkirk, Hacksaw Ridge, 1917, Midway, Fury, Warhorse, Red Tails, April 9th, just to name a couple. But I'm sure you're aware some of these films didn't come out so well. After watching war films from 1930 to modern day, from Poland to Vietnam, I'm beginning to build a perception of when a war film is fantastic and when it's not. A few specific things helped me along. Reading first-hand accounts, watching veteran interviews, doing my own tests, and most importantly, learning how to be an effective filmmaker. Because it's one thing to try and understand a historical event, but it's a totally different thing to adapt it into a film. And people who understand history better will say, the story must suffer. While people who understand storytelling better will say, the history must suffer. And I'm here to say that it's actually possible to accomplish both, without generalizing Asian cultures, without showcasing made-up atrocities, and without a dollar store romance plot. First, let's get the obvious stuff out of the way. Fury is a movie about US tank crews fighting the evil Nazis. The US tank drivers are in a column. The German tank commander in the film forgot to read his booklet labeled Shoot the Front, Shoot the Back, Blow the Last and Roll it Back, and died to Brad Pitt because, oh, it's so handsome! In Hacksaw Ridge, a movie based on the real actions of Desmond Doss, not a single person ever runs out of ammo or reloads in this film at any point, and the Japanese soldiers attack our freedom-loving youngsters, played by actors 40 and up, in a suspiciously similar way to the Vietnamese in Mel Gibson's other incredibly patriotic film. This film would be horrific if it didn't look like an advertisement for Action Essentials Bloodburst 01. Midway is an awful film made by an incapable director whose favorite pastime is to give notes to the VFX department on how this shot could definitely look faker. This movie is also stocked with over-the-hill actors trying to play kids, but this time they're British actors trying and failing to mask their accents.
Yeah, I'll take that bet.
And since they crammed not one, not two, but three major naval events into a single movie, things like the Doolittle raid take literally seconds on screen, and completely forget that the attack was a low-altitude bombing run. Like, this low. I guess if you're trying to bomb the moon, it counts as low altitude. Now let's take a step back. The one thing these films share in common is that they're all American-made. American audiences love to be taken on a ride, and there's no easier way to cash in on them than with a true American hero story. If you're like me, and your little American heart's getting worn out from all the same American heroes winning the war for your freedom again and again, I recommend to you European war films. Take a break from the glory of war and have an honest, subtle perspective of conflicts during World War II. Our neighbors across the channel are master storytellers who feel no need at all to make you feel like you're watching Star Wars and more like you're peeking through an unfiltered window into the past. Incredible films like The King's Choice, April 9th, and the Finnish miniseries The Unknown Soldier. Honest and authentic depictions of events as they occurred, featuring things like realistic engagement distances, non-fireball artillery barrages, actual infantry tactics, and a cast of the appropriate age. All without a hint of that guy from Jurassic Park 2 and the lady whose eyes are really close together. The issue with American films is that you need name recognition. So we get 50-year-olds like Brad Pitt and Vince Vaughn playing starring roles. American audiences like a thrill, so you gotta lay the tracers and explosions down real hard. And you gotta have a hero story, so the script has to be padded to accommodate one. Maybe someday Hollywood will have the capacity to greenlight more films like Saving Private Ryan and 1917, but for now I'll be getting my fix from TUNTAMATUN SOTELAS! NAHARAN SEURA VASA VIDIOSA USTAVANI!